Good evening and welcome to the Whiskey Lover Society with me Gert de Tief. And tonight, doing a little bit of an unboxing. Quite excited. I actually ordered this whiskey about 2 weeks ago. It only arrived about 3 days ago. So I was looking for the perfect timing and the perfect opportunity to do a little bit of an unboxing. It is, of course, samples from my favorite online store. So in this box we are looking a little bit of a scotch, and we are going to make a turn in India just because I love the Indian whiskies. So the nice big box that arrived, and again, just for the people that have never watched my video, it is an online store that whatever whiskies you want, most probably you will find it there. They do make up their own samples, so it is not a distillery sample. So they take small little bottles, well, quite a generous 50 milliliter bottles, and then you can see which ones are available. They send you some paperwork, and they give you all of the samples, what it is, and what is the cask strength. So they don't give you a lot of information, but they actually do wrap it quite nicely, so it's well protected. A lot of newspaper, sometimes it's bubble wrap, sometimes a little pillows that they give you with it. So they do pack it well. So I'm just going to take them out. Sometimes they do tend to overkill. So they do number it. And then of course you just look at the documentation that comes with it and you'll see what it is. So I'm quickly going to unravel everything. Maybe do a quick fast forward so that I don't waste too much of your time. Eventually unwrapped all of them. So we're going to start off with number one. And with number one, they don't give me a lot of information. The only thing that they tell me, it is the Ben Riach cask strength. Batch number one, bottled at 57.2% ABV. Now, this is not my first Ben Riach. I did a couple of reviews. And the one, of course, that really stood out for me was the Ben Riach Curiositas. I think that for me is one of the best peated whiskies that I've ever tasted. And so this is not a peated one. So I'm quite looking forward to seeing the Ben Riach. It is quite nice color to it. Of course, I don't know if it's any chill filtration. I don't know if it's any color added. This I will add in the future when I do the review on it. So the next bottle is the Boonehaven, and of course I have no idea how to pronounce it, but at least you have a photo of it. I will have to go do a little bit of research. It look like it is the Boonehaven Sturiader. I no idea, but of course I'm quite looking forward. I did love the Boonehaven 12. That for me was one of the best sherry bombs that I've had in a long time. So a big favorite one, the Boonehavens. So I'm looking forward to try this one. It is bottled at 46.3% ABV. The next one on the list, number three, a nice little light in color. And of course, this is the Gordon MacPhail. The MacPhail's collection. This is the Bel Blair 10-year-old single malt, very light in color, and it is well, they don't say anything about the ABV, so I'm gonna have to do a little bit of research on that one. The next one is bottle number four, also a little bit darker, and this is the going to India part, and I do love the Indian whiskey, especially the Amrut. I did, I think, two reviews of the Amrut, the cask strength, and the single malt. And I'm quite looking forward to see what they do with a little bit of a peat whiskey. This one is bottled at 46% ABV. So quite looking forward to this one. Next one, bottle number five. And bottle number five is staying in India. I've heard so many good things about Paul John. And a couple of the people of my subscribers also said I need to give them a try. I know they know what I like the Amrut, so I'm looking forward to see what the Paul John is going to be. This is also a little bit of a peated one. It is called Paul John Bold, bottled at 46% ABV. And as I said, a little bit of a smoke on it. So quite looking forward to that one. And of course, the last one. And I think color-wise, it's quite a little dark one. So I'm looking forward to see what this is going to bring. This is also Indian whiskey, the Paul John. And this is the edit edition, single malt whiskey, bottled at 46% ABV. So six bottles. And I think I've got another about six or seven bottles still on its way. So this is something that you will see in the next couple of weeks. Looking forward to nosing them, tasting them, giving my reviews on them. And as one of my subscribers has said, maybe that I seem to be enjoying the international whiskies much more than the Scotch whiskies. So that made me think maybe I should invest more of my time and my money into whiskies of the international variety. I did love the Japanese whiskey. I did like the Indian whiskey. I did like the Belgian whiskey. I did like the French whiskey. So now, in the next couple of weeks, I will be digging around all the shops in my region and all the shops online to see how many of these international whiskies I can find. They are fantastic. So thank you very much for watching. Please leave a comment if you have a recommendation for a international whiskey. Which ones would you like to see? And I will see if I can find a sample of that. So see you next time, and have a great evening. Cheers.